is in the periphery of the inner sphere, so it's like the bottom 10% of the larger inner sphere map.
And the reason we chose to set the game here rather than kind of in the major large warring factions, the five noble houses that are fighting here, you can see we're on the below those. This is kind of the banana republics, right? If you think about it, in the Cold War, where the major forces are playing politics down here with all these minor kingdoms, and we're there, where we're a small mercenary unit to start, up in the main thing, we're just not big enough to matter. Down here, we're a big enough fish in a small enough pond that even our four mechs start to have an influence on the local geopolitical situation. And we do get to engage as we grow, as you grow your mercenary unit up, you will start to engage with the larger houses and their politics. But right now, it's we're focused, like for instance, on that one local kingdom and trying to get that crown back, and the other kingdoms in the area. So, but you are freely able to navigate, right? It's not like an RPG, which is on a route. You can move. You choose which planets you want to go to. You choose who you want to negotiate with. You choose that the contract specifics, and all that builds reputation with the different geopolitical groups in the area, which will then determine who offers you contracts later and at what kind of benefits.
3025.
Yeah, we set this at the 3025 time period, which was the setting of the initial board game, kind of after the third succession war and before the fourth. And our hope in success is that we can move through the timeline, much as we admire how Paradox has done with their historical games. Ideally, we can do that the same with this one.
We would love to have Forest Fires.
We would love to. It is not going to be in the initial releasing product. Okay. It is one of the things we'd love to get into in a DLC in the future.
Yeah, right.